Over to the my right, your left, the Congress, the House of Tears, Congress you will hear in a little bit, but what the power of this Totem Pole is that it's brought together people from Snake River, from Chaco Canyon, from Line 5, up in northern Minnesota, of the tribes in northern Minnesota, the Crystal Bay Indian community, the Sioux St. Marie tribes who are working to stop the Line 5 pipeline from desecrating their sacred waters. The Arctic, Crystal Bay, it has brought so many nations together. There are too many sacred places to name. All of those sacred places deserve to be protected. We are all speaking in one voice for sacred places, protecting sacred places now. Our sacred places are part of the beautiful lands and waterways and oceans that we live with and among. All who farm, who fish, who hunt and hike must join tribal nations and native communities to prevent the destruction of Mother Earth. We are building a politically empowered movement that will show not only are we ready with solutions, but we will also show that we are strong because of our traditional cultures and our traditional ways of caring for Mother Earth. Today you will hear from tribal elected officials, traditional leaders, and grassroots community organizers. Those are the three elements of being able to build a politically empowered movement that can protect not only sacred places, but also achieve tribal sovereignty. There are many people who've gathered here to honor the House of Tears carvers from the Lummi Nation, to honor the prayers and hopes that this Totem Pole has brought to D.C., and to speak with the Biden administration and Congress. But most of all, we are here because it is the time to end climate crisis, to end the policies that have been dictated by the extractive fossil fuel industries. There are many people who are in the audience that I wish I could recognize all, but I would like to welcome former Secretary of the Interior, Sally Jewell, who's here in the audience. We also have Congressman Hawaii, Representative Kaikili. Thank you for coming. Thank you for standing with us. And now I'd like to introduce Doug James. So, I'm sorry, we have to change things a little bit. I'm sorry, Deb. Now we will hear from Chairwoman. I shouldn't even say live tech. Chairwoman Brenda Gallery, who is the chairwoman of the council. Sorry, my iPad just shut off. 21st Century Indian Problems, the iPad. The chair of the Council on Environmental Quality.
It's an honor to be in your presence.